Pietro Fittipaldi, the driver that had the spotlight for a record 23 minutes before George Russel so rudely stole it by moving to Mercedes for Sakir. Yes, that value was exaggerated for comedic effect. Seriously though, no one was really talking about Pietro, mainly because there wasn't much to say. Nevertheless, I thought it'd be interesting to have a look at whether or not he could return to Formula 1, when Mazepin inevitably gets sucker punched by Gunther Steiner for sending half the grid to an A&E unit. So, will Pietro ever appear in Formula 1 again? We will answer that today. Pietro Fittipaldi was born in Miami, Florida on the 25th of June 1996 and is obviously the grandson of the great Emerson Fittipaldi. I can't find a thing about him having any sort of karting career, which I must admit surprised me. He began his racing career, however, in the NASCAR Waylen All-American Series, winning the track championship at the Hickory Motor Speedway in 2011. Later, he proceeded to move to Europe to take part in British Formula Renault Championship in 2013, along with a few other open-wheel disciplines. In 2014, Pietro won the Pro Tyre at Formula Renault Championship. Normally I'd compare this to other people in the series, but I honestly don't recognise any of them. So, I guess. In 2015, he took part in the FIA European Championship and came 16th, being utterly destroyed by the likes of George Russel, Callum Ilott, Alex Albon, and Charles Leclerc. However, the most important thing is that he beat Mahavir Raghunathan. The same year, he won the MRF Challenge Formula 2000 ahead of Mick Schumacher. What an achievement. Wait, Mick took part in 4 races. Oh, but at least he beat Tatiana Calderon. In 2017, Pietro won the World Series Formula V8 3.5. Oh, come on, I don't recognize any of these names either, apart from Calderon again. Since then, he's done nothing of note, if you could even consider that noteworthy. So Pietro so far has won a few irrelevant categories and simulated a McCulloch M115 97T ride-on lawnmower and the others, even IndyCar. So how the hell did he get the role of test driver for Haas in 2018? There's literally nothing significant about him. Oh yeah, his name. If it weren't for his surname, he'd probably be working a 9-to-5 job in the local chippy. Or whatever they have in Brazil. That's the most British thing I've ever said. Chances are, if you were good in Formula 1, your children or grandchildren will just get a free pass into motorsport. Most of the time, it's completely justified. For example, Mick Schumacher, the guy who's trying to end everyone's career, and a young girlfriend stealer who also likes the colour orange. However, of course we get examples of drivers who don't deserve a drive. I'm gonna give you a quick tour. Exhibit A. Giuliano Alesi, single-handedly responsible for 90% of HWA staff losing the will to live. Exhibit B. Pedro Piquet. I completely forgot he existed. And Exhibit C. Pietro Fittipaldi, the M&S version of Mahavir Raghunathan. So I'm going to pass you over to a slightly more socially relevant tour guide to analyse this spectacle. Please welcome the racing pilot.
Pietro Fittipaldi, the driver who's somehow in the shadow of his younger brother Enzo, who's in F3. Nah, I'm joking. But at least Enzo's actually doing Formula 3. Pietro was signed as Haas F1 team's test driver in 2018 and has tested multiple Haas cars since then. Imagine being born into an F1 family and being able to just get a job driving an F1 car without nearly as much experience as most. Well, Pietro doesn't have to. Fittipaldi attended the first session of pre-season testing in 2019, along with the post-season test the same year. But this would be the last time that he drove an F1 car until Grosjean's horrific accident. Due to Roman's horrific injuries, Haas needed a replacement, and quickly. Many people speculated that it would be Louis Delatraz who would get the seat, but no. Gunther Steiner decided to pick Pietro. Like Dylan mentioned at the start, this was big news, until Mercedes and George Russel had to steal the spotlight. Therefore, Pietro Fittipaldi went largely unnoticed. I suppose one thing that came out of it was the title of the first grandson of an F1 driver to also race in the sport. But that was kind of the only thing. Anyway, I'll pass you back to Dylan to tell you about how it went.
Can I just start by paying tribute to Louis Delatraz? If I were him, I'd fox smash Steiner's door.
He does not fox smash my door, tell him that.
Anyway, due to the audience being distracted by Russell's fantastic drive, Mercedes' second attempt at the most shambolic pit stop award, and Jack Aitken having a quick chat with a barrier, I'm pretty sure people forgot Pietro existed. He would come last of the finishes at Sakir and Abu Dhabi, making his couple races quite forgettable. So will we see him again? As a full driver, I seriously don't think so, because he's all name and no game. Yes, I just made that up while writing this script, and it kind of works. He simply isn't good enough to be considered a full-time driver by any team, so it just doesn't make any sense for Haas to sign him full-time. There's another guy who some of you may not know. Oh yeah, Callum Ilott. Furthermore, Pietro is somewhat of a controversial character in Brazil. One of my subscribers DM'd me this information on Instagram, go follow me if you haven't already, and I found it interesting enough to look into it further. The president of Brazil is a man by the name of Bolsonaro. Bolsonaro was accused of many things, including being homophobic, racist, and supporting the dictatorship that Brazil had between 1964 and 1985, which was awful for the country. If I get any information wrong, my Brazilian viewers, please let me know. Pietro Fittipaldi openly supported Bolsonaro in the 2018 election, which was controversial to say the least. So it could be argued that Pietro doesn't deserve that seat any more than Mazepin. With that said, however, this information is arguably biased and unreliable, but to be considered nevertheless. In the likely event that Mazepin hospitalizes half the grid including himself, we may see Fittipaldi stand in as a reserve driver again, even though it should be Louis Delatraz. So in conclusion, I do not believe that we will see Pietro Fittipaldi in Formula 1 as a full-time driver. I believe the most likely event is that Mick or Nikita contract coronavirus and Pietro sit in for a one-off. Anyway, as usual, they are just my opinions. Let me know yours in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video enough to watch more, please remember to subscribe to the channel as well, and I will see you all in the next video. But until then, take care and follow me on Instagram at DylanJamesF1. Thank you for watching.